Earth. It's pretty big. In fact, everyone I know is here. It's gonna be a long time before we go over here.
Mars, kinda small, but I can't complain. But before we go here, we must go there.
We have to figure out how to save our future here.
What we're dealing with right now is climate change. Climate change is a change in global or regional climate patterns, which is caused by atmospheric carbon dioxide produced by the use of fossil fuels. And fossil fuels is a natural fuel such as coal or gas, formed in the geological past from the remains of living organisms. What also causes climate change is solar radiation. It's a general term for the electromagnetic radiation emitted by the sun. And you may ask, how is this connected to the CTE? Well, I think welding has our answer.
What even makes the satellites? Well, with a substantial amount of materials available, only two make the cut, titanium and aluminum. As titanium is hard to mine and fabricate, most satellites are made of aluminum and its alloys. Aluminum is lightweight, durable, and relatively cheap. Welding combines the metals to shape the shell for the satellite. Thanks to our technological advantages, we have a wide display of different alloys and metals to create the shell of such a satellite.
But where do electrical engineers come into play? Electrical engineers design, build, and test electrical systems. That's the specialty of electrical engineers. They also develop the wires needed for the satellites to function properly.
How does information technology help make satellites? Well, computer programs are used to make the satellite work from Earth and in space. It transmits signals and commands for a program to use, mainly the information. You could describe IT's function as a thought process.